Hey y'all. This is a redo of my original video. I didn't share my screen properly, so I'm having to do this again. And thank you to the couple of people who pointed it out to me. There is a TikTok video that's been circulating. This brother by the name of Randy Pyron. That's really got some women upset, a certain group of women upset, not all the women that he's poked fun at, but just a certain group of women. And I'm going to share the video, the first video that got everybody's bowels in an uproar. I'm going to share the first video, and here we go. Okay, so a lot of people, let me go back for a second here. A lot of people weighed in on this video. So I need to go here and please bear with me because I want to show you some of the people who weighed in on who had something to say about it. There's a lot of people had something to say about this particular one, starting with Mr. White Zaddy here.
If my Jewish mother saw me disparaging Jewish women, or any women for that matter, online for clout, she would end me. That'd be it. And look, plenty of you are going to say, hey, sit this one out. It's none of your business how black men talk to.
Okay, because it is none of your business, but okay, continue.
Black women. You're right. I'm not tone policing this guy.
But that's exactly what you're doing.
But I am particularly disturbed by this video because black women, dark-skinned black women in particular, are probably the most patient people on this planet. Because they themselves are the victims of more violence and vitriol than any other group ever. So yeah, to hear that they're being labeled as innately violent by a black man might be especially hurtful. But again, I know this isn't my business, and I'm not going to tone police this man, but I do wonder what his black mother thinks about this shit.
And I wonder what your black mother would think if you brought home one of these patient black women. They probably would end you too. So I want to see, because nobody had anything to say about these other videos that the man did, because he did a whole bunch of videos clowning women. So let's go back to Mr. Randy's page and check out the other videos.
After all that, this is what I found. Nobody wants to be alone. If you're touched by the words in the song, then baby,
you got it bad.
Okay, so no outrage over this one. No Karens came, making any rebuttals. They had nothing to say about this one. Here's another one. Okay, and my favorite.
It's bounding with desire, waiting to be unleashed. Quit breaking my heart.
Ooh, dude. canceled. Anyway, my point is that nobody had anything to say about any of these other videos that he did, clowning brown-skinned women, light-skinned women, white women. Oh, here we go. Black people.
Listen, baby. Ain't no mountain high. Ain't no valley low. Ain't no river wide enough, baby.
You need me, call me, no matter where you are, no matter how far.
Don't worry, baby.
Just call my name, I'll be there in a hurry. You don't have to worry.
Oh, baby, there ain't no mountain high enough. Ain't no valley low enough. Ain't no...
This is what he does. He's a clown. He's a comedian. He just... Okay. I think that I'm over the fake outrage by a certain group of women. So let's go back to the fake outrage real quick. I'm not going to dwell on it because it's BS in my opinion. I'm just not. No outrage for anyone else, but they want to cry. Oh, no. I shared the same page. I'm so sorry, y'all. I'll figure it out. I could hear Nick Taylor screaming at me. Okay. Here we go.
Which part was supposed to be funny? It's y'all in the comment section just eating it up, and it's not even funny. But yet, as soon as a white person or a coon bucket say this same thing, y'all in an uproar, y'all so upset. And I'm even pissed off that y'all even having me have to say anything like that. Ugh. But where y'all think they get it from? Everybody who thought this was just so hilarious, you and fake ass Wale, have a bad day.
Okay. And here's another one.
Did you know that one out of every three black men will be incarcerated at some point in his lifetime compared to one out of every 17 white men? Did you know that one out of every 18 black women will be incarcerated at some point in her lifetime compared to one out of 111 white women? The idea that blackness equals violence at the being darker skinned equals violence extends past men. Black women are more likely to experience violence from friends, from strangers, domestic violence, SA, compared to almost everybody else, and that gets worse the darker you go. I know the impact of colorism. He knows the impact of colorism. He made the joke anyway, and 76,000 of y'all laughed.
Anyway, colorism crybaby. I'm not going to pay any attention to that. So, nope. And as far as white zaddy goes, dude, you're going to have a completely different experience with that woman than a black man is going to. And that's all I'm going to say about that. Anyway, that's it, y'all. It never was meant to be long. I'm not going to give this a whole lot of energy. Like I said, miss me with the fake outrage. Have a good evening, y'all. Bye-bye.